and charges may apply. It's SmackDown. It's Tuesday night, September 4th.
This week, WWF Metal is brought to you by Warner Brothers' new motion picture, American Outlaws, in theaters everywhere, starting Friday, August 17th.
I love boots and shoes, tough enough to handle anything.
And by Burger King, in the land of burgers, Whopper is king.
Oh, this should be a good one, Kevin Kelly.
Very physical battle forthcoming. Hugh Morrus, chiefly responsible for Albert losing the Intercontinental title. Those two men
come to the schedule for one call. Introducing first, representing the Alliance, weighing 280 pounds, Hugh Morrus.
You know what I wish I were expecting would be? What? A six-month vacation.
Well, of course, Hugh Morrus, part of the Alliance, where the mindset of Shane O'Mac, Stephanie McMahon, Helmsley, and Paulie seems to be attracting the young, the hip, what's happening now, and tired of the old guard of the WWF. Yeah. And I've got to ask a question about somebody who could be primed for recruitment from the Alliance.
From Boston, Massachusetts, weighing 350 pounds.
Listen to the reception.
Albert!
He's starting to earn a lot of respect from the fans of the World Wrestling Federation.
Earnest key word.
With a lot of hard work, a big-time physical competitor in Albert. He's trimmed down a little bit in the waist, but hasn't sacrificed any of his strength. He can press anybody over there, over his head. The Baldo Bob garnered him the Intercontinental title. Hugh Morrus and a cast of thousands helped Lance Storm take that title over to the Alliance side. I think Albert's going to be looking for revenge. But let's talk about recruitment from the Alliance side. Somebody that could be a prime target is Kane. What is the deal? There seems to be a lot of rumors swirling around. Do you think that they are actively going to be recruiting the Big Red Machine?
I think that the Alliance will recruit all people on the WWF roster. I think no one's safe. And the one thing about the Alliance is that there's a weakness in the way you're being treated or a specific thing that you cater to. We're going to make sure that they turn that weakness into positive if you join the Alliance.
Hugh Morrus has started off very quickly against Albert. He has to find a way of allowing the big man to extend those arms. Because Albert is so dangerous.
I mean,
that's true. He's a consummate salesman, and I know he thought he had the Rock sewn up and ready to go to the Alliance side.
It felt like it.
Yeah.
Being in that arena, it's real. When the Rock rock bottom, Mr. McMahon, you went, okay.
War's over. Werber dropped a big one. Everybody thought it was going to be off. She rode. If Rock was joining the Alliance side. But instead, finally, the Rock has come back to the WWF. What about the words the Rock spoke about what the WWF means to him on SmackDown?
Said he didn't come back for Vince McMahon, he came back for the people. And that's great. That's a nice setup.
You're a man of the people, too?
No, not at all. Are you kidding? That's what I want to know. I got to ask The Rock. Rock, have you ever met so many people? I mean, have you ever seen the couch?
Well, we'll, of course, relive the moments of The Rock's return. But a little bit later on, as Albert's getting some revenge for the loss of the Intercontinental title to Lance Storm. Hugh Morrus, chiefly responsible.
Talk about ugly referees. Billy Silverman looks like an anteater that got shaved and is walking backwards.
Well, we'll see if Billy Silverman calls it fairly. Of course, Nick Patrick's refereeing and character constantly in question. Literally screwed Kane out of the U.S. title this week, allowing Canyon to keep that title.
Who better than Canyon?
I don't know. In Canyon's mind, nobody. But certainly Kane was about set to win that matchup. A controversial decision. You know, you got to wonder how long this is going to be allowed.
About the Alliance taking the color commentary position.
Well, you might say on the surface it's a bad thing, but if there's anybody who can keep a Paul Heyman in place, it's JR. And if anybody can keep Taz verbally in place, it's Michael Cole. Let the other side be heard. Sure, that's fine. I got the strength.
Wait, I agree.
Oh, big splash. This should do it. No, sir. Hugh Morrus kicks out. That guy's tough.
I agree. JR keeping Paul Heyman in place. Michael Cole keeping Taz in place. How hard is that?
Well, true.
I mean, you know, Michael Cole says something and Taz just follows with the repaint.
Well, we'll see what the, you know, the Alliance getting their viewpoint out there. What's that going to mean? Oh, in the upcoming weeks. And what's it going to mean?
Morrus with the clothesline. Belly to back suplex.
You know, seriously about Taz, Taz brought up some good points, and I hope Mr. McMahon was listening. Because Mr. McMahon has mistreated people in the past, as we know.
Hugh Morrus goes to broke.
And maybe he can learn from his mistakes. Mr. McMahon will make the same ones. Look out!
Michael, yo! In from behind, our referee doesn't see my chin track for the Alliance. Crunch out with an EDT.
You've got to be ribbing me.
Well, he didn't see it.
What? You couldn't hear that?
I don't know. Two. He got. Now we're not done yet.
He had to have heard that at least.
Albert was able to kick out as Silverman's hand coming out of the third time. And now, once again, Chindrick gets involved. Uh-oh.